Liriodendron tulipifera, tulip tree. This is a tree reaching 80 to 120 feet tall and should not be used for small residential properties. It's just too big. Over time, it will develop a broad pyramidal form to its canopy. The foliage is deciduous and alternate, and usually is 3 to 4 lobes with a broad apex. It has a distinctive broad truncate apex with short acuminate lobes. It's usually bright green above and paler green beneath. The leaf is very distinct, and although it is tulip shaped, the name tulip tree, common name, comes from the flowers, which are perfect, consists of 6 greenish to yellow petals in 2 rows and 3 reflexed sepals. The inner corolla is often orangish in color, and these flowers are present on the tree from May through early June. The flowers often occur high in the tree canopy and may not be seen from the ground. Besides the flowers, other ornamental features of tulip tree include the grayish brown furrowed and interlaced bark. They produce cone-like aggregate samaras that are 2 to 3 inches long, turning brown in October and persisting through winter. The cone-like aggregate samaras can be a good winter ID feature. Another ID feature of Liriodendron tulipifera is the duck bill-shaped bud. Cultural information for Liriodendron tulipifera. These are hardy from zones 4 to 9, will do best under full sun conditions. They tolerate soil pH from acidic to alkaline, 5.0 to 8.0. There can be a number of different insect and disease issues, including cankers, leaf spots, powdery mildews, verticillium wilts, aphid scale, and more. These tend to be a fairly fast-growing tree, upwards of 15 to 20 feet over 6 to 8 years, especially if there's ample water, fertilizer, and space. These are best transplanted in spring from bald and burlap stock and will do well in deep, moist, and well-drained loam soils. The root system can often be fleshy and poorly branched, which is a consideration for their transplanting and establishment. It can develop leaf scorch and die out over time when planted in narrow tree lawns without adequate root space.